Before I even got into Resident Evil, I knew it as that one video game franchise that keeps getting horrible movie adaptations, and later, that one video game franchise that got a Netflix series which was apparently the worst thing in the world, according to my friends that like the game series. And now that I'm actually somewhat into it, aka just here for the hot guys, my opinion hasn't changed at all. I'm sure you all know by now that the whole reason why I got into Resident Evil in the first place is because of this fine young gentleman named Albert Wesker. You know, as someone who's really attached to his character and pretends to be his alleged wife on camera, complete with dead animal skull on forehead, just kidding, it's actually rubber, you'd probably be curious to know what I think about Netflix's iteration of the character. And well, I have some really complicated thoughts. Let's talk about it. First of all, I would like to start out by saying I have no hate towards the actor Lance Reddick. He did a great job. He saw the absolute dumpster fire of a script and took it upon himself to somehow be the only one to take it seriously. I have a lot of respect for him. If I was in his shoes, I could not do that. The thing that everybody brings up with this casting, though, is the fact that they cast a black actor as a character who was originally white in the source material. And I can understand being disappointed with the casting or not liking the actor that was chosen for the role, but there is a fine line between complaining about show decisions and just generally being racist, and there's a lot of people who have crossed that line very intentionally. It doesn't matter to me what skin color my fictional crushes have. I didn't fall in love with the original Wesker just because he was a white guy. I love the fact that he is superhuman, he is beyond what we consider perfection in society, and he's just a being that is physically impossible to exist in the real world. And that is exactly where Netflix went wrong. If you look up a compilation of just the Wesker cutscenes from any of the Resident Evil games, you will see a bunch of really cool non-stop action sequences with moves that are just physically impossible to pull off in real life. And it's almost fantastical in a way, like, wow, I wish I could be as cool as this guy, you know? Now, if you look at a compilation of clips of the TV show's Wesker, you will see him sitting at his desk and talking, sitting at a desk and talking, sitting at a desk and talking. Oh look, now he's standing up and talking. Standing up and talking. Oh wow, he's actually kicking butt. Yep, back to standing and talking. I don't know if this is my screwed up conception of love, but I kind of find it hard to fantasize about a guy that just works an office job and does little else. Isn't the point of a fantasy to escape from your everyday life? I just can't picture myself in a relationship with this new version of Wesker because he seems too much like a real person to me. And the thought of me being in a romantic relationship with someone really makes me uncomfortable because it would be loveless, really. I'd just be putting on a charade, you know, pretending that I'm in love when I really don't feel those feelings towards real people. And if I wanted to date such an average person in the first place, I'd have to conform to the ideals of what people think is attractive in a woman. I mean, first of all, I'd have to care about whether people think I'm attractive or not, and then I would have to basically just destroy my entire identity just so I can feel love that I don't actually feel or understand. I don't see how a relationship like that would benefit me in any way. And hell, if I had to fit the ideal of what's attractive in a woman, I'd have to give up all my clothes and exchange it for a trendy closet that everybody else in the same neighborhood wears. No more funky makeup, I'd have to hide the fact that I'm autistic, no more costumes, no more masks or role-playing. I just couldn't be myself anymore. What does this have to do with Albert Wesker and Resident Evil, might you ask? Well, in the original Resident Evil games, it's set amidst a zombie apocalypse. Nobody is going to be worrying about upholding stupid societal standards when they're fighting for their lives against hordes of zombies. But the Netflix one is just real life with worse dialogue and the occasional zombie. I have a very big imagination, full of ideas for things like scary movies, which are not going to make any money at the box office anyways. So it's no big stretch to imagine that the big buff, bullet-dodging, egotistical guy likes me, and just likes me for who I am. Perhaps the most pleasurable fantasy of all is just being comfortable in my own skin. In short, the reason why I don't find Netflix's take on Albert Wesker attractive at all is because he's just such a boring character. In fact, he's so boring that he seems more like a real-life person than a fictional character. And that's not what a fictional character is supposed to make you feel. This man could move in right next door and I wouldn't give a care in the world because he is just a normal person. No quirks, no passions, no individuality, no freak flag to fly. These are not the kind of people I want to surround myself with, whether fictional or real.